Thanks for switching on this Carrie and Tommy podcast. The Chemist Warehouse Half Price Sale is also on right now. Get big brand vitamins and cosmetics for half price. Terms and conditions apply. Chemist Warehouse, great savings every day.
Carrie Bickmore
and Tommy Little.
This is Carrie and Tommy.
Yes, it is. Welcome to Tuesday afternoon. How are we doing, guys?
Good.
Yeah. What?
Yeah. Are you? Because you look like from the outside you're falling apart.
What would give that away?
Just the fact that headphones are already falling off.
Hands I think I've had too many coffees.
Do you? How many you had?
This is my fourth for the day.
Okay.
Too many?
How many shots are you having in those?
Double shot.
No, Jesse meant vodka, but the answer happens to be the same. So that's good.
Too many?
Because huge show coming up, so much coming up. Obviously, chance at $1 million, that is on the line. We've got a brand new game for us a bit later. We're going to talk about, it just says your wild Saturday night.
Oh, I can't believe I didn't tell you about it yesterday.
I know.
I can't believe it slipped my mind. It was the most important part of my weekend and I didn't share it with you.
That's great. Well, up next, I've got something that you've been drinking that you will know nothing about and I will blow your mind with a fact about it.
Carrie and Tommy.
It's your Tuesday afternoon. Carrie Bickmore and Tommy Little.
You know why it's called Murder on the Dance Floor, right?
Why?
Because the dance floor dies.
Yeah.
And then you want to murder the one bloke that's left on the dance floor, which is you.
Yeah.
Jess,
I'm happy. I don't care.
No, you're not. You're dead in that story.
No, I wouldn't know.
Hey, Bickers. I got nothing else in my life but food at the moment.
You do. You're doing a lot of cooking.
Yeah.
You even inspired me the other day.
What did you make?
You made sausage rolls. I made sausage rolls.
They were so good.
Yeah, mine weren't that good. And I thought, I need Tommy's recipe.
It's real good. They were. I'm not exaggerating. They were the best sausage rolls I've ever had.
I think it's because normally you meant to do sausage meat and pork. And I did pork and beef mince. And I just think the beef mince ruined it.
Oh, good. Anyway, beef or pork, give us a call. We mentioned on yesterday's show about gherkins, pickles, cucumbers, all the same thing, right?
We're not going to have that chat again.
We're not going to have that chat again. The only reason I tell you that is because it's all I've been talking about lately.
Also, we never got a real conclusion.
Gherkins is American.
Okay,
I sent that to you after the show.
I know, but on air we never got a conclusion. Let's not
gherkins
have this
is just the American.
In America, you get a pickle on your burger. How can it be a gherkin?
Not according to the one person who sent me a message on Instagram.
You don't get a gherkin at Macca's in America.
I do, mate.
It's a pickle.
Yeah.
It's different pickling.
Okay. Oh, why else?
Sondo, you're away. Anyway, I told one of Dan, who works here at the project, and he said, oh, man, I've got one for you. He said he learned years ago about this this method where you could reduce soft drink to like a syrup and then make it into ice cream. So you could make an ice cream that was the flavor of your favorite soft drink, right? And I was like, oh, wow. So you could make Coke flavored ice cream. And he said, yes. He goes, and I was so excited to try this. He goes, it took forever, right? Because first you had to reduce the thing.
How do you reduce the thing?
Don't know.
Okay,
I didn't get
not
to
the
that,
point
right?
of your story. Don't
not
ask
the
questions.
Point. He reduced and he said his favorite drink was creamy soda.
Oh, yeah.
Right? And there's also a debate whether it's creaming soda or creamy soda.
I think creaming.
Creaming is a bit too disgusting. But anyway, so he reduced his creaming soda to a concentrate. Right? And
syrupy.
Then he made that into ice cream. And after hours of doing this, he was so excited to taste his creaming soda ice cream.
Sounds delicious.
And then he took a mouthful of it and he went, this is so weird. Mum, this just tastes like vanilla. And his mum went, well, which? Sonda, with a shit-eating grin, nodding
I already
know this, guys.
Especially if he gets its radio.
I know. And his mum said, what soft drink did you use? And he said, creaming soda. And his mum said, well, darling, that's why it tastes like vanilla, because that just is vanilla flavour.
What do you mean? Creaming soda is just vanilla flavour.
It's vanilla soda.
So,
Sonda,
what?
Tell them.
Is you that, can bring she'd your, know this, you she'd know this because smug, she's American, because her mom was from
mom.
America.
Oh, my
mom. Yeah, it's vanilla flavored.
In
yeah.
America?
No, just
here.
Everywhere.
Here.
That's what
creaming soda is. It's vanilla soda.
So when they do vanilla Coke, it almost tastes like red creaming soda.
Well, it's creaming soda mixed with Coke.
Wow.
Yeah. I know.
God, that's amazing.
Isn't it? Can you?
Don't ask Sondra if she can top that. She'll have 50 also, million fun facts. They stop being fun when it's just one after the other, isn't
Even
it?
Even when I bought you in to be smug about it, for some reason all your performance disappeared and you went, yeah, it's vanilla.
Right. You absolute idiot. Everybody knows that.
No, they don't.
The least exciting fact in the world.
Did you know that? No.
No
one
knew it.
Jesse, did you know that?
No idea.
No? Carrie, did you know that?
Why is it pink then?
I'm surrounded by losers.
Maybe you're the loser.
I'm sorry. Okay. You're surrounded by losers who also don't know stuff.
Yeah, idiot losers.
Yeah. This should be 13-10-60. How dumb are you?
Yes. No, no, we're not dumb, mate.
Sorry, I forget.
Have you got any?
We're smart now.
Have you got any food facts for us that are going to blow our tiny mind? I had no idea the creaming soda was just vanilla soda. I had no idea that pickles were cucumbers. Tasty cheese and cheddar cheese. No, that's another one. Anyway, give us a call, 13 10 60. Blow our tiny minds. Not Saunders, because she is a jerk.
Carrie and Tommy. Carrie and Tommy.
Around Australia for your Tuesday afternoon on 13 10 60, we are taking your food facts.
Was that song from the Coke ad?
Oh.
Back in the day?
Yeah, maybe.
Brothers and sisters together. Anyway, I feel like it was from the Coke ad.
Jesse, we're not doing food facts. We've got to sex it up a bit. We're blowing people's minds. Sorry, that one happened in my pants. The next one will be a mind-blowing.
Because you just told us what?
That creaming soda is actually just vanilla soda.
Vanilla flavour.
Well, vanilla soda, yeah. Why do we have to do?
Because it's called red creaming soda. So if you say it's just vanilla soda, it's confusing. Mm. What you're trying to say is it's vanilla flavour.
Soda, yes.
Dave, it's stopped being fun. Can you make it a fun food fact?
Can you ask Dave first if he knew about the creaming
soda? Did you know about the creaming soda, Dave?
I did. Sorry, guys.
Damn it. Okay, Dave, can you blow our minds?
The flavour of the lolly banana was originated from a banana that does not exist anymore. It's extinct.
What? Hold on. What do you mean? It just tastes like sugar.
Well, the flavouring that they mocked was from a banana that grew a while ago and then got eradicated through disease.
Dave, I love it. Do you know what it was called, that banana?
I have no idea. That's as far as my facts go.
That's okay. It was still good. And Carrie is not being open enough to having her mind blown here.
No, I just... When I eat a lolly banana, I don't think of actual bananas because they just taste like lollies.
It's because it's extinct.
Extinct, yeah. Yes. Yeah, good.
Imagine if you had bananas that taste like that.
Danielle, blow our minds.
I'm still gobsmacked on the fact that creaming soda is vanilla.
Thank you, Danielle. It was mind-blowing, wasn't it?
Take that up with Sondra if you want to tell her it doesn't make sense, because apparently everybody knows.
Hmm.
Everybody knows that, Danielle. What
Never.
What bit didn't you know? Did you not think it was a flavour when you drank it?
No, I love creaming soda, but it literally just tastes pink. So vanilla's like more bland.
Pink's a colour, mate, not a flavour.
Yeah, well, it has a taste.
Yeah.
It doesn't have a taste.
Danielle, I'm with you. Things that are pink,
like
generally
Ribena.
You associate them with, or some
You associate
berry.
Them, you don't taste them. Your brain says... That's
so
a raspberry,
what
or that's a
what
strawberry.
What colour is vanilla? Not so smart
Well, it's brown.
It's brown.
Yeah, vanilla paste is brown, and so if you had made a cake that had vanilla in it, you'd have little specks of brown vanilla bean in it.
And how come vanilla ice cream is white?
Because people are racist.
She's starting
what
to reach.
What a weird thing to panic on.
Cracks in her argument. Sean.
Why couldn't you say they put white colouring in it?
Sean, what's your fun food fact?
Well, first of all, I'm going to shout out to Romani.
Oh, good man, Sean. He hasn't been getting many lately, so good on you, Sean.
And also, carrots weren't originally orange. They got genetically engineered to be orange because they're more appetising.
What were they originally?
I'm pretty sure they were purple.
Oh, because I was going to say there are still purple carrots.
The purple carrots, weirdly, have become the fun carrot.
Yeah, well, they're the original ones. The Dutch changed it to orange.
Oh, the Dutch. Sondra, anything you want to say about it?
What about, isn't it interesting? Because what's the one that looks like a carrot but tastes horrendous?
A parsnip.
Parsnip.
I thought you were kidding.
I thought you were going to say what I was pointing to.
And a turnip. A turnip and a parsnip. What's the difference between them?
One's louder.
But either way, isn't it interesting that they taste disgusting and they look disgusting?
It is. It's fascinating. Can we go back to Sean just for 1 second? I've got another. Oh, he's gone. Okay.
Sarah's okay. Got something to add. Sarah, what fun food fact did you want to bring to us?
So this one's a bit weird, but okay.
It'll fit in perfectly.
Microwaves were originally invented to defrost hamsters to reanimate them from cryogenic sleep.
Sorry.
Before it was invented for food, it was accidentally discovered that it can cook food.
Oh, those poor hamsters.
I feel so sorry for the hamsters, because if it's anything like my microwave, a bit of the hamster would have still been freezing, yet a bit would be 100 degrees.
Carrie Bickmore.
And Tommy Little.
This is Carrie and Tommy.
Right around Australia for your Tuesday afternoon, it's Carrie Bickmore and Tommy Little.
How annoying would this be? Actually, I have a question. Who is the real winner in this situation I'm about to tell you about? Okay. There was a marathon in the UK,
yes,
right? And the planners accidentally made it 500 metres too long, and they didn't know. So the race was being completed, and with 200 metres to go, the guy that had been front the whole time, number two came out and overtook him and won the whole marathon. And then they discovered afterwards it was 500 metres too long. So does the guy who was leading 500 metres before the end, does he take the crown? Or would that other guy have overtaken him earlier if he'd known, in which case he is still the winner?
At that level, I'm assuming you said he won, right?
Yeah.
So at that level, the training is like so meticulous that he would train to exactly a marathon.
So who's
length.
The winner there?
The guy who was ahead at the 42.2K.
Oh, there we go. Better call the UK and tell him to get him back.
Get him on the phone.
How bad's that though?
Yeah.
Like, especially whose job after it is
that
to,
far.
Yes.
I know. Hey, what's coming up, Bickers?
I can't believe I didn't tell you guys yesterday, but I had the wildest Saturday night.
Oh, swingers?
Yeah. Oh, you'll have to wait and see.
Okay.
Maybe. Over Zoom.
Oh, gross. You get a virus.
Carrie Bickmore.
And Tommy Little.
This is Carrie and Tommy.
Carrie and Tommy's $1 million alpha bucks is coming up a little bit later on.
I don't know about you guys, but I feel like crazy times call for crazy measures. You know, we're in lockdown. It's hard to find things to get excited about.
Yeah.
And everybody in their own little way is doing their own little thing in their family just to have a little, like, little peaks in the week. Otherwise, it's a lot of troughs, you know?
A lot of nothing.
So, the new thing we've started doing in our house, because Ollie, Chris, and I are watching Ted Lasso. Awesome new show on Apple TV.
Yeah.
It drops every Friday night. Like old school, you have to wait each week for the next episode.
It drops.
Yes, it drops, man.
Have you guys
drops.
Started saying that, man? It drops, man.
It's lit.
It drops.
Anyway,
it's lit, man. It drops.
Last week, we made the radical idea of not watching it after it dropped.
Oh, my
gosh.
What did you do when it dropped?
We didn't. We just left it.
Oh, my God.
Just left it on the floor.
You know what that means, though? It means
you can double
this
drop.
Week we're going to double drop and we get to watch two lassos in a row for a bit of Friday night fun. If that's not enough for you.
Hang on. Wait.
We've just double dropped. I don't know. I think you've got to let us come down a bit before you bring us back up again. Your night got wilder than...
No, my Saturday night. The next night.
So after you had the dizzying heights of not watching TV.
Yeah.
You had more in the tank.
Oh, you wait till you hear. So, like a few months ago, a Saturday night was Mardi Gras, you know, Troye Sivan, partying. Yeah. Nah, not this Saturday night.
Did you drink too much that night?
Okay. That was a shorter night than I planned. We haven't discussed that, have we?
How many times did you call Troye?
Stop.
She doesn't remember.
Sorry, Troye.
He's not listening.
He's at Met Gala. He's definitely not listening.
He didn't even listen to your individual phone calls.
He said he was going
to
come,
Sorry,
though.
Sorry, you reckon he listened to the voicemails?
We are not. No, even if he did, he couldn't understand them. You need a translator for, hey, Troye,
I don't sound like a dog when I've had a drink.
Mate, 42, you do.
Hey, Troye, boy.
I did not sound like that. Anyway, my Saturday night.
Sorry. Yeah, back to the wild.
It's just so much wilder.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So it was about 7:32. because I put the kids to bed at 7:30.
Party time.
And I grabbed my peppermint tea.
Oh, God.
And I went into my bedroom, sat in my bed, opened my phone. I ordered a 5-set, first time ever, never done this before, of period, period undies.
Oh. Let's get ridiculous.
So, Moddy Body.
Moddy Body, is that what they're called? Moddy Body?
Everyone, I keep seeing these ads for Moddy Bodies. I'm like, what's a Moddy Body? And then all the young people have been telling me, you don't use pads and tampons anymore. You use period undies.
Because I feel like an idiot because I feel embarrassed and I'm out of the loop. Should I get myself some Moddy Bodies? Are you trying to get an endorsement with Moddy Body? Is that what's happening here?
You haven't partied.
Hey,
Troy. Moddy Body.
Hey, Troy. Have you Moddy Bodies?
Anyway, so I thought I'm going to get on the Moddy Body train.
Wow.
And I bought myself some period undies, guys. That's my Saturday night.
Wow, Bickers.
Yeah, I know. I'll let you know how I go. I haven't tried them yet.
Do you reckon anyone can top that? Oh, please do. Please do keep us updated. But not on air. I just want the usual 2 a.m. voicemail. Yeah,
2 a.m.
Moddy Bodies.
Try to let Troy know.
Yeah. Can anyone top that? Can anyone have a more wild
My producer said that
weekend.
I need to clarify what period undies are.
What do you mean? It's pretty self-explanatory, isn't it?
I understand, Belle.
What do you mean? Clarify.
I'm telling you they make them for men for incontinence.
I thought you were saying I had to explain what a period undie was. Yeah.
So Tommy can party too.
Oh, my God, we can be the double face. His and hers.
That's so fun. Hey, Joy, I've got some for you too.
Give us a call, 131060. Tell us about how wild
your weekend
did you
was.
Get. I mean, we know we all can't not watch TV and get period undies, but do your best to top it.
Carrie and Tommy.
Driving you home this afternoon, it's Carrie Bickmore and Tommy Little on 131060. How wild was your Saturday night?
You can take your Met Gala, you can take your MTV Awards, because Saturday night I ordered period undies. And sorry, that followed Friday night when I could have watched the latest ep of Ted Lasso that dropped, but instead we decided as a family we were going to hold it for a week. So this Friday night we can double drop.
Let's get ridiculous.
Small wins. Small wins. What did you get up to on the week? Oh, yes?
Why is doing two episodes, like why deprive yourself of a bit of joy on Friday night?
Because it's like an extra, then a real, like, because it became our Friday night thing, so it was a bit mundane. So now it's like, it's a special night of Lasso.
Yeah.
Because when one ep finishes, you want to go to the next, but you can't because it's only dropping weekly.
Damn.
How did we do with that in the 90s?
Next Friday is going to be so exciting.
Isn't it? Yeah. It's this Friday. It's only three more sleeps, guys.
Oh, my gosh.
Sonda, what did you get up to on your weekend? What wild things did you do?
I rotary hoed.
Oh.
Why didn't I get music?
Yes? So I didn't think you got to the end of it.
Oh, I hired a rotary hoe and hoed my garden.
What does sound wild. To be fair, I'm like, how much did that cost you an hour?
$270.
That's the price,
for a rotary hoe?
Well, I had to hire a ute and
how much
a
is one that doesn't rotate?
What is a rotary hoe?
It's a machine that hoes your garden, which just means cuts up all the dirt.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah.
So it looks a bit like a fork going into the ground or a knife going into the ground?
Lots of blades.
Rotary hose. Yeah, a rotary hoe. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Yeah.
And how did that go?
Really good.
Yeah.
I hoed that garden so good.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you sow your seed?
I haven't sowed any seeds yet.
Why?
My husband will do that.
Will he?
Yeah, he will. Yeah. He loves planting.
I was potting some plants.
Sam, can you top any of this? Talk to us about your wild weekend.
So I was invited to my best friend's baby shower, which was also her gender reveal, alongside with her relationship's one-year anniversary, plus then her partner proposed to her on that same day, and it was also her birthday. All in one event.
I mean, that's an actual good day.
Well, that is a partner that doesn't want to have to remember more than one date, isn't it?
That's it. That's exactly it.
And tell me you're in a state that... Oh, shout out to Romani. Oh, sorry, Sam, I cut you off.
Good on you, Sam.
No, that's okay.
Because he's getting jealous about how much attention Romani's getting.
Tell me, Sam, though, I have to ask you, are you in a state where all of those things happened in real life, or is that all on Zoom?
No, in real life. I'm in Brisbane.
Oh, my God.
Apparently walking in to go and be vaccinated as we speak, so...
Give her the music, Jess. Give her the music. That's what we're going to be doing in summer, guys.
Ooh.
That's it.
Sam, can you smuggle us into Brisbane, please?
Oh, as long as you pay the fine, Tommy.
That is absolutely fine.
Justin.
I get it.
Justin, I'm ordering period undies. What are you doing with your wild Saturday night?
Weird first move.
Well, my wife finally made me get up on the roof to get rid of the giant wasp nest up in the gutters.
Oh.
She would have been happy with that, though, Justin, was she?
I really wasn't, but she really was.
Yeah, yeah. Happy wife. Yep.
She even had the camera out ready for me to fall off at any moment.
Carrie and Tommy.
Yes, it is. And coming up, $1 million is on the line.
$1 million. Isn't it great to work in a job where we can literally change people's lives?
Awesome. Because... So awesome.
And speaking of that, I want to do more of it. So...
I felt like that wasn't as sincere as I thought it was going to be.
No, this is sincere.
Okay, sure.
If you have missed out on something due to the pandemic, whether it be a holiday, it might be a major life event, it might be a party, we have a solution for you.
Do we?
Next.
How do I not know about this?
Stick around. We don't tell you the good ideas.
Carrie and Tommy.
Elton John and Dua Lipa, that is Cold Heart. It's Carrie and Tommy this afternoon.
Now, Bic, as I said just before Cold Heart there, that people have missed out on things due to the pandemic, and it's our privilege here that we get to right some of those wrongs.
I didn't know about what this is. Are we giving away holidays?
See,
what are we doing?
Here's the thing. Although I teased what was coming up,
yes,
it's actually not my idea.
Oh.
It's the young weasel over there who's going in his whiskers.
Oh, it's Jesse's idea.
Yeah.
Well, guys, I thought radio has the power of the theatre of the mind, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to find some people with some experiences that they've missed, and you guys are going to make them feel like they're experiencing it with some sound effects that you're making.
That's good.
Sorry, we're making the sound effects with our mouth?
Yes, yeah. Yeah, like I've actually made a little opener for you that explains it.
Sure.
And this will give you an opportunity to practice your sound effects. Okay,
so we've got to fill in the blanks.
Yeah. So just fill in the blanks with whatever appropriate sound you think.
Okay.
You could be relaxing at the beach. You could even be driving a race car.
You do it.
Or even eating a baguette in Paris. You could be anywhere with Carrie and Tommy's Theatre of the Mouth.
It's not spooky.
It's a good finish.
I mean, I guess you might want to be somewhere spooky.
You haven't been in my mouth.
So we've got producer Pip in here for the first person who has missed something, and you guys are going to help her experience it.
Pip, what have you missed?
My hen's night.
Your hen's night. Now, Pip, obviously it wasn't going to be just you at this hen's, right?
Oh, no. Me and my heaps of girlfriends that I have.
This is great.
Oh, my God, Pippa. This is the best hens I've ever been to. Hey, Pippa, do you remember the penis straws? I'll see what they sound like when I try and sip my drink through one.
That was a lot, Pippa.
Hey, lovely lady, when's your wedding?
Well, it's not my wedding, it's Pip's wedding over here, but what's your name?
I'm Sven, the stripper.
Oh my God, Pip. Who is this guy? What's his name?
Oh, wow, this is better than I could have ever imagined.
Pip. I'm Sven, mate.
Oh, hang on.
Pip
sounds better than she'd ever imagined. Yes, you're Pip. Pip. It's your.
Oh, God, someone's already called up to take part.
Oh, no.
It's great.
I don't think we can do that.
I mean,
one, can
he's
we?
Chosen to call up, but I think lot.
I think he might have called before he heard our fun example.
Yeah, because that's not fun. That's so sad.
What music would you do?
No, we're not doing that.
Yeah, let's go. Let's get back into. Give us some music. Let's get back.
Okay, back to the party. What's another song? What about Doong 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 Doong?
Oh my God, Pippa.
Doong, 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 doong. Ah!
Pippa, have you organised any other activities for this hens, Pip?
Yeah, what about the pin the...
Yeah.
On
the stripper? On the Andrew.
Who's my husband to be?
Okay. Oh my God, I'll go first.
Oh my God, you missed so much. That's his head.
Oh, guys. That's my head. Oh, is he a cardboard cutout?
He's a cardboard cutout. Yeah, he's Andrew's not at the hens.
No. Okay. Don't be an idiot.
Okay, so 13, 10, 60, yeah. If you want us to act out those moments that you've missed, it's almost like you'll be there. Like, it'll be hard to tell the difference.
How could you not get involved?
I don't know what the difference was between the real thing or that right
oh,
now.
Oh, no.
That
your hens
so
wasn't going to be that fun. Yeah.
Yeah. 13, 10, 60 is the number.
Carrie Bickmore.
And Tommy Little.
This is Carrie and Tommy.
That is the latest one from Ed Sheeran. It's called Shivers. It's Carrie and Tommy this afternoon.
What are we doing, Jess?
We are in the middle of our brand new game. Are you ready to practice your sound effects again?
Yeah.
You could be relaxing at the beach.
Splish splash.
You could even be driving a race car. Or even eating a baguette in Paris. You could be anywhere. Carrie and Tommy's Theatre of the Mouth.
So many things that people have missed out on.
Yes.
And this is almost the same as being there. In fact, it's you better. Probably don't even need to go once it's you've better. Been part of our journey.
It's better. It's better. Sarah, what did you miss out on?
I missed out on the birth of my first grandchild.
Oh, Sarah.
Okay. Yep. Well, the good news is, Sarah, did you know the doctor or nurse's name? What's they called that deliver the baby?
The obstetrician?
That's going to be me.
Midwife? What would you like to be?
I'm the midwife.
Great.
Do you know that means with wife?
Does it?
Yes. That's why.
So it's the woman that's helping the wife? With
well,
wife?
No, because midwives can be men as well. It just means you're with wife.
But is that where it came from? No, you're just
you're
with the wife.
Wife. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Did you know that, Sarah?
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, thanks. There we go. Anyway, because you can do some sound effects,
sure.
I'll be here with Sarah.
Firstly, Sarah, welcome into the birthing suite here. Oh, watch that door behind you.
Bump.
Oh, God. Sarah, be careful with the floor there. It's a bit slippery.
Oh.
Oh. And Sarah, tell me, Sarah.
I can't do it anymore.
How do you know my patient here?
I can't do it anymore.
She's my beautiful daughter-in-law.
Oh, good on you, Sarah. And I should have asked this as a doctor firstly, but what's her name?
Her name's Nicole.
Nicole, well, you've arrived just in time for the big
is that
show.
My
that's what I call it. I shouldn't call it the big show. The small show that's getting bigger.
Is that my mother-in-law?
Yes. Yes. Would you like to chat, Sarah, to Nicole?
Oh, you're doing great, darling. Just keep going. It's all worth
it. Get out the room. I want everybody out.
No. One more big push. And all right, it's out here. And it's crying. Sarah, would you like to have a quick hold?
Oh, yes, I'd love to.
Oh, it stopped crying instantly that you've held it, Sarah.
Oh.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't get emotional. I'm a doctor and it's so nice to be here.
Sarah, how was that? Did it feel like almost as good as the real thing?
Oh, that was awesome. I mean, I wasn't there, so I'm not exactly sure, but I'm sure you've done a great reenactment.
Yeah,
it would be just like that, I'm sure.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you. Let's go down to Nick. G'day, Nick.
Hey, legends. How are you?
Yes, very good. What did you miss out on, bro?
Well, first of all, just a quick shout-out to Romani.
Good man. Very good man.
And second of all, I missed out on a heaps of bloody live concerts, especially the Veronica's, Keith Urban, Youngblood, which I had tickets to. Can you please give me a little bit of a shred?
Would you like...
You take it away. You're the shred machine.
Do you want to hear me shred some
Keith Urban?
Some Keith Urban.
I love you.
It's going to be hard for me to shred Keith Urban. Twiddling ding, twiddling ding, ding, twiddling ding, twiddling ding, ding, twiddling ding, twiddling ding,
ding. Oh, now I'm at the Veronica's concert.
Ding, ding, ding.
Do you feel like you're there, Nick?
Mate, I'm actually speechless. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Did you want Youngblood while we're here?
Give it a go.
I'm a geezer. How's that?
Mate, I felt like I was in front row. Thank you so much.
Good man, thank you.
Sonia, what did you miss out on?
Oh, look, my lovely wife and I, we missed out on our honeymoon cruise around New Zealand.
Oh, this is perfect.
This is a tricky one, isn't
Sonia,
it?
Sonia, you didn't miss out on it all, because you just happened to be walking onto the boat now.
Oh, fantastic.
Oh, no. G'day, Miss and Miss. Welcome to your honeymoon cruise. Do you know what room you're in?
I think it's the red one.
The red one. Very romantic. Good choice there, Miss. And you, Miss. Come this way, Mrs. Let's go this way to the red room.
Are you going
to
leave them on their own now? Hey, a bit of one-on-one time?
I was hoping to get in.
Carrie and Tommy.
Carrie and Tommy this afternoon, thanks to Chemist Warehouse. Great savings every day. Right now, get half-price big brand vitamins and cosmetics at Chemist Warehouse. Terms and conditions apply.
Hey, Biggers, how good is this? As Jessie just said, all big brand cosmetics, half-price. All L'Oreal, Maybelline, half-price.
It's amazing.
Guess what about Rimmel and Sally Hansen?
Half price.
And all Revlon and Nude by Nature.
Amazing. You know what else they sell?
Half price.
Sorry, half price. You know what they also sell at Chemist Warehouse? Uh-huh. Nappies. I go there a lot for my nappies because
they're not
my
on my
house,
list of half price stuff, mate.
I'm not saying they're half price. Oh. I'm just saying they do stock them there.
Yeah.
Because we haven't toilet trained Addie yet. And I've tried and tried. I can tell when she's doing a poo. I say to her, why don't you use the potty? She says no. And then I end up changing her. It's quite a tyrant type relationship.
Yeah.
That's developing.
She's ironically wearing the pants and not wearing them at the same time.
Anyway, breakthrough in the cow world that has made me think I'm maybe doing things wrong with Adino toilet training. Mm-hmm. Apparently, right? Mm-hmm. So the issue with cows is their urine is high in nitrogen, right? And it's a major water pollutant and emitter of nitrous oxide, a greenhouse gas, right, that accounts for 12% of New Zealand's greenhouse gas emissions. And they're like, how can we get the cows to stop urinating everywhere and start urinating in one spot?
Yeah.
So they put these things around their neck that zapped them when they urinate in the wrong spot.
Oh, like we had for the quiz that day.
Exactly. Yes. I don't think it harmed them. It just gave them a tiny little shock. And so they taught them where they wanted them to urinate. Mm. And then over this three-week period, like three quarters of them learnt to urinate in that spot. So what I've worked out I need to do is just get a shot collar of hay.
That's fantastic.
And maybe this is the way forward for toilet
training. That's great. What? And so obviously they wouldn't make them for humans. So we need to get one.
Oh, yeah, because it was a dog collar, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, but so what size do you reckon Addie is in animals?
Probably a dog.
Yes.
She does like to walk on all fours and get Evie to pretend she's a pony.
Yes. And I mean, people do pick up after their dog and you are picking up after her. Because it's genius. I can't wait to see the authorities get called in when you try it. Hey, up next, chance at $1 million.
Carrie and Tommy. Carrie and Tommy.
Happy Tuesday afternoon. It's Carrie Bickmore and Tommy Little. The paper quiz is coming up next.
$1 million Alpha Bucks.
Alpha Bucks Millionaire.
Whoa. I've just read what Megan's going to do with her $1 million if she wins it. Megan, you're insane.
Just a bit crazy, yeah.
You're meant to do something fun when you win $1 million, not say you're going to run the world's marathon, 7 of them to be exact.
Mm. Yeah, it's pretty crazy, but that's what I'm like. I kind of like a bit of a challenge, so yeah.
Megan, I reckon you should shoot one higher. I was trying to remember what it's called because I ran a marathon with a guy who had
like
done
in
it.
Antarctica or something.
No, so you...
Tommy has done that.
I have done.
Drop that in.
Yeah. But one guy there, he was completing it. So all 7 is a club that you become a part of. But there's one more. It's called like the Big Up or something. And it's all 7 plus the North Pole.
Oh, God, no.
Yeah,
I don't like
the
cold.
But then,
I hate
you know
the
you've,
cold weather.
But Megan, you know to do the Big 7, you've got to do Antarctica.
No, you don't. It's not part of it. Not the world majors. No, it's not.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
She's got a
I'm sorry, Megan.
She doesn't like the cold and she will not be running.
Sorry, Megan.
It.
You don't want to be uncomfortable when you're running your marathon. That is fair enough.
It's hard enough to add the cold element into it. That's just crazy. So kudos to you, but no way am I doing that.
That's fair enough, Meg. Well, we hope you win. There are
I've
a few
got a good
rules.
Feeling.
Yes, there are a few rules. 30 seconds you have to answer all 10 questions. We take your first answer. Can't use the same answer twice. All 10 correct, 10 grand is yours today, Megs, but then you also get a spot on $1 Million Day. You know what to do. Pass if you don't have the answer. We'll come back if we have time. And your time starts at the end of your first question. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, no worries. Let's bring it on.
Your letter is T for Tuesday. T, okay?
Yep.
All right, let's play. Name a mode of transport.
Taxi.
A number.
10.
A bathroom item.
Towel.
Something in a gym.
Treadmill.
A movie.
10 Things I Hate About You.
A camping item.
Tent.
Something sweet.
Sure. Coffee apple.
An iPhone app.
Oh, sorry. Oh, my God. I should have put my phone out and had a look. I'm sure I've got something.
Oh my God. I so wanted you to get it, Megan. Megan, you were very good at first. I was thinking, because I know you're a nurse, Megan, I was thinking you're good under pressure.
Oh, my God. Was that the last question by any chance?
It was, no, there was two more, a type of dance a magazine.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I would have had those two as well. Oh, my God, that's ridiculous.
How often do you swear at your patients?
Underneath my mask pretty frequently.
Megan, we could have taken TikTok.
Sorry about that. I'm a bit of a potty mouth there.
That is absolutely fine. Totally go fine. For it. We would have taken TikTok, Tinder, Twitter.
Oh, my God. Things. And half of those I have.
Oh.
It's okay. You did awesome. And you can re-enter. So if you are like Megan and want to get involved, just download the listener app, search Carrie and Tommy, fill out the form. That could be you.
Carrie and Tommy.
Carrie and Tommy for your Tuesday afternoon. And coming up after 5 o'clock, we've got a clue for Carrie and Tommy's $1 Million Alpha Bucks.
Ooh.
Right now.
Yo, Jesse.
Yeah, dog.
You got that paper ready?
Yeah, dog.
Carrie and Tommy do that quiz from the newspaper. We do the questions first and we get them answered. Later. Most exciting radio quiz of all time. Carrie, Big More, Tommy, Little, put your hands up cause it's quiz time. Quiz time. Quiz time. Quiz time. It's time for quiz time.
Yeah. 5 out of 5 last week as well, I think.
Been doing well.
What newspaper you got there today, Jess?
It is the Mercury from Tassie.
Good.
Awesome.
Man.
Give it to us.
All right. Question number one. What is the Beverly Hills Cop theme song?
Oh, yes, it's
Is it The Heaters On?
No. Is it?
No.
No, I feel like it's
Oh, that's annoying.
Sorry. It's getting
into my head. Didn't a pop star recently use this for something?
Yes. It's all coming to me. Dua Lipa? No.
It was Rita Ora.
Rita Ora.
So who would it be originally?
What song? What's that called?
What is that?
It's the Crazy Frog Guys.
Oh, that was all wasted, wasn't it?
Is it called? No, okay. I went to say no.
No, I don't know.
It's Axel F.
Oh, jeez. Axel F.
God?
Who's Axel F?
Where did that voice come from?
I remember reading that recently because of that Dua Lipa song and the Crazy Frog song. I know lots of
I think
about
it's Rita Ora,
Frog.
But yeah. Yes.
And and God, don't just for God. The people's reference, whereabouts in Australia are you phoning in from?
God's country.
I'm in God's country, Ipswich, in my bedroom.
Yes. He's everywhere. There's some people listening in Ipswich
God
now going, which
one of
these? In his
bedroom in Ipswich.
It's great.
It's a lot, isn't it?
What are you God, what are you wearing?
Just a little hoodie, boardies and pluggers, yeah.
God always had the pluggers on.
Yeah, sandals. Mm. Big sandals,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah. rough terrain to walk over without the pluggers on.
Yeah. Actually, if God came back, prime candidate to be the face of Birkenstock. Yeah.
All right, let's go.
All right, question number two. What motorcyclist is known as the Doctor?
No idea.
Valentino Rossi.
Oh, there you go. Bang.
Question number three. Kigali is the capital of which African country?
Kigali. Kigali.
I just want one of the answers to be Chad. Like, I've always wanted an answer to
be
Chad.
Great, let's do Chad then. Chad.
Question number four, what is the pen name of English author Mary Ann Evans?
J.K. Rowling. I know. The only authors I ever remember are J.K. Rowling and Patricia Cornwell. Do you think it's either
of
those?
Older. Much older.
William Shakespeare.
It's a woman, isn't it? Oh, well, or, it's a pen name. No, it's a pen name.
Hmm. Or a nom de plume.
Is it T.S. Eliot?
Great stuff.
Great, let's go with that.
Which stands for, one of the full names there. Tina.
Sophie. How do you think of
Tina? Tina Sophie Eliot.
No, yeah, same. Okay.
Tiny, yeah.
Yeah. Question number five. Pitch blend is the main ore that is mined to extract which substance?
Sorry? Pitch blend is the main ore to extract which substance? Is it, I don't know, is it oil or something?
I'm assuming, is it like, you know, black as pitch? I was looking it up for etymology the other day, pitch black. And pitch is like tar.
But don't you make, but don't you make tar?
Maybe.
But it'd be a metal, right?
Sorry, I'm
like
thinking bitumen.
Or. Yeah.
Isn't it a coffee?
Isn't it a coffee? See you later, Eli.
The old coffee mines.
Black tar. No. Yeah, if it's got to be a metal, then I don't know.
It doesn't have to be a metal, does it?
Well, I just saw iron ore. So which
That's
ore?
Right, yeah.
Do that.
I said.
Sorry,
oh,
which
but
ore?
I actually don't know.
I didn't
know.
Even see. No, there was an ore in there. Didn't even listen.
I've got no idea.
Or maybe it's iron
maybe
ore.
Maybe it's either ore.
Tar. Okay.
Okay.
So do we have any kind of answer for that? Or we're just going
iron
tar?
Iron ore.
Iron ore? Okay, cool. Question number one. Which is the Beverly Hills Cop theme song? It is Axel F.
Yes. Oh.
God, well done, God. The goods.
Yeah. God. Treat yourself with
Thank
some
you,
water. You know what to do with it. Sorry, that's your son. I'm so sorry. Walk on it. Oh, God. Imagine going to that party. Where, don't worry, guys. I walked on it. You were meant to turn it to wine.
Now your feet's been all over it.
Now we've just got
the
foot.
Trick.
Now we've just got foot water. Oh, gosh. Walk on it.
That would be, if you were at a pool party and all of a sudden somebody walked across the pool, that would be a memorable party.
Yes, but if you found out that was the other option,
sorry, only if you didn't know there was a bee.
A better option. Yeah. That included other people instead of just the one selfish walk of water.
No, I reckon I would take the walking on water over the wine. Because you'd already have that flowing, the wine. Obviously. It'd be an added bonus. Anyway,
seeing
we're done.
Yeah, we're getting bogged down. Sorry, yeah, we are.
Gogged down. Shut up.
Thanks for getting us out of that one, Beast.
Hey, I've been thinking a lot about my comment yesterday when I told you were a jerkin.
Yes.
I said you were a gherkin.
Yes.
And it really brought me a lot of pleasure last night.
What are we just saying back our favourite things that we've said?
I don't say them very often. When
you
I do, they
do,
stick
mate.
With me.
That's just not true. Anyway. I mean, you haven't in this break, but
I'll come through at the end with iron ore, you watch.
Question number two, which motorcyclist is known as the Doctor? It is Valentino Rossi.
Well done, Tommy.
Question number three.
Chad.
Oh, this is a Tommy question. Question number three, Kigali is the capital of which African country?
Please.
We said Chad. It is Rwanda.
Oh, so close.
Same continent, bro.
Drinking Chad and Rwanda.
It's all right, mate. We still got two more questions to get to after this, so you got plenty of time to bring that heat.
Okay. Yeah. Next one, please.
Question number four. What is the pen name of English author Mary Ann Evans?
Oh, we said tiny. No. Yes.
T.S. Eliot.
It's George Eliot.
Oh. T.S.'s brother.
There's that heat I was looking for.
Give us the last one.
Oh, I thought we were done.
Question number five. Pitch blend is the main ore that is mined to extract which substance? Because any gear before we finish this?
No.
Uranium.
Oh, don't.
Carrie and Tommy. Carrie and Tommy.
That is where you're at for your Tuesday afternoon. If you're after $1 million, you're in the right place.
Oh, and we can even get you just a little bit close. I wouldn't call it a full step, but definitely a little shuffle close to that $1 million.
Are you going to give us a clue for tomorrow morning's 8 a.m. million-dollar alpha bucks?
I am going to give you a clue for the clue.
Oh.
What do you drink 5 minutes before we go on air
Johnny
every
Walker.
Day. Yes, correct.
Amazing.
Your clue for tomorrow morning's 8 a.m. game of Alpha Bucks is Johnny Walker.
Hey, when I think medical advice, I'm sure you feel the same. I think Nicki Minaj.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
my anaconda.
Yeah, whenever I've got issues with my WAP, yes. I turn to Nicki.
I mean, they're different people, but that's fine.
Are
that's
they?
Fine. Yeah, yeah.
What do you mean?
You've got your pot references wrong, but that's all right.
He's still, what?
You've got to go see Cardi B for that.
Cardi B.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You'd be there, legs akimbo with Nicki Minaj.
She'd like it, though, I reckon. Anyway, up next we're going to talk about the Met Gala, which she wasn't at. Apparently, Sonda was telling me this, because she wouldn't go because she wasn't vaccinated. Mm-hmm. Is that right? And you had to go. You had to be vaccinated to go.
Did you?
Anyway, she's tweeted about vaccination. She said, my cousin in Trinidad won't get the vaccine. Cuz, C-U-Z,
cuz
his friend got it and became impotent. His testicles became swollen. His friend was weeks away from getting married. Now the girl called off the wedding. So pray on it, you know. Make sure you come to with a decision. Don't be bullied.
Just a quick, do you reckon cuz is lying to get out of the wedding?
About the big balls.
It's a long way to go. Also, like, how do you make that happen?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, great question, Jesse.
Ask Cardi B.
Seriously, no, how do you do that?
Jesse, you need to see Nicki Minaj. The three of us, let's go together.
Carrie and Tommy.
You drive home this afternoon, it's Carrie Bickmore and Tommy Little.
When I think Tommy Little, I think fashion.
Thank you. It's about time someone sat up and taken notice.
I think a colourblind man is the perfect man to give an appraisal of the outfits on the Met Gala red carpet.
Valet, that time I accidentally wore a purple suit that I thought was black to the Logies.
But little did you know you were being fashion forward.
Oh, God.
You know? Without even knowing. I'm going to hand you some images because they're always out there. Met Gala's always out there. I'll be honest, I've never given a flying about the Met Gala.
Wow. That made me nervous.
Not into it. Ooh. I don't know why. It's always been a bit too out there for me. But this year, for some reason, I think it shows you the levels of desperation that my life's at, that I looked at it. I loved it. It gave me feelings of what life could be like post-lockdown.
Yes.
And I got excited.
So because here's what I know about the Met Gala. I actually don't know what it's for.
I don't really know either.
But I do know it has a theme every year.
I feel like it's something to do with that woman who's old, Anna Wintour.
It's all for Anna Wintour.
Why is it? What's it?
When do you get to put that break in your name? Like that's Anna Wintour.
No, because her name's not T-E-R, it's T-O-U-R.
I know,
so it's
but
it
doesn't matter. Anywhere around the world, that's Wintour. Tour.
So it's Carrie Bickmore.
Yes, I have the answer.
Oh, God.
Oh, yes. Sorry, Belle.
Okay.
Yes, the Met Gala is a fundraising event for the Metropolitan Museum of Arts Costume Institute. And you're right.
That just come off the top of your head?
No. It's organised by Vogue editor-in-chief Anna Wintour.
Great. Awesome.
Yeah, good stuff. What is the theme this year, please, Annabelle?
America.
Oh, that's why. I saw one of the basketball players and he had the American flag on his head in spray paint.
I did see that. That is not one of the ones I've got you to critique.
Okay.
Now, for people driving or at home thinking, I can't see these images, don't worry because Tommy is going to paint a picture for you. First of all, I give you Kim Kardashian.
Oh, great. She's in a giant body. She's back Catwoman. Basically,
Catwoman, but with something over her head.
Yes, she's got a burqa that they've forgotten to cut the eye bit out of. She is going to walk into walls.
Yeah, and I wondered how she could see it.
Oh, you know what she looks like? She looks like a puppeteer. She looks like she's backstage, ready to operate a puppet, but doesn't want anyone to see her, so she's covered in black. And is that Kanye
Maybe she is being operated by Kanye, because apparently he had a say in her outfit, and apparently it's a tribute to his, is it Donda? Am I saying it right?
Donda.
And there was speculation that was him on the red carpet, because people thought they were going to reunite and make their debut. Anyway, apparently that guy is part of the designer, or one of the designers for Balenciaga, who designed her outfit.
Do you know what this is a great outfit for? When you don't actually want to go to the event. You can't see one inch of her.
No.
And that could be any petite woman under there.
No, see, I think disagree with that, though. You can't see one inch of her, but yet her silhouette is very Kim Kardashian.
Nah,
you know that silhouette anywhere.
Oh, I don't, but that says
you
a lot
do
about
so.
Your mental undressing, you sicko. How do you drink with that on? How do you?
Do you not make me laugh?
To, to go to the Dunny,
yes.
This would be a
oh,
real...
Oh, no, you don't go to toilets or red carpets.
Sorry, I'm
the
such
hard way.
An idiot.
You know how she's got her full face covering there?
Yeah.
In her credits on her Instagram, she gave her makeup artist a shout-out.
So, okay. Because what if you need to go? Is it just a funnel-type situation?
Nah, you just get a whole lot of women to help you in a little cubicle, and they all pull up while you pull down.
Isn't that funny?
Yeah.
Because if that was men, they'd pull up, and then they'd run away and leave you stranded with your dress around your ankles.
Okay, go with the guy in that one. Who's that?
I've got ASAP Rocky here. He is dressed in a doona that is multicolored.
Yeah.
Next to
like
what
Nana's,
is
Nana's
happening
doona.
In all this?
Like a rug.
Because he's in a he's in a quilt kind of thing.
Yeah, quilt thing.
And then Rihanna has just forgotten to take her doona off. She's in a black doona with a beanie on.
It's fashion, mate. It's
that
fashion.
Would be so hot.
What's he got there is his little, it doesn't have a handbag.
Oh, it's Frank Ocean.
What's he carrying?
Frank Ocean has got a little leprechaun doll here who looks like a tiny doll of Chucky. And I'm assuming the only reason he would carry this is if it's filled with drugs or something to get it in.
I don't know.
What's
going on?
Is that
what you think's happened there?
Well, I heard that old story about Diego Maradona where he used to rock into places with a soccer ball. And so he'd get off the plane and he'd have a soccer ball.
No way.
And apparently, I don't have to say allegedly, he's dead. Apparently.
Still his name is tarnished by your story.
Allegedly, on occasions, that was filled with the booger sugar.
Wow, that's very smart. Not that I'm condoning it.
Yeah, I know.
Is that
but anyway, I reckon you knock the head off this doll.
What about Kim Petras? Is she holding on to that, the same theory happening there?
Kim Petras is dressed as a horse.
She's actually got a horse head on.
She's got a horse head on her chest.
Yes.
And her norks are the horse's eyes.
Yes.
Isn't this a terrifying thing? Are they her hips or is that a bit of added work going on?
I think that's a horse's ass.
You could. Is it? Is it? That's. You could rest a drink on that, couldn't you?
Yeah.
And who's Amman down here?
That's gorgeous. That is next level amazing.
She's dressed as a peacock, basically, isn't she?
More than a peacock.
No, how do they sit down? How is anyone, for a table of 10 people,
I think what
you need to have a boardroom.
Is they go, they get changed after the red carpet so that they can go hang out. Somewhere here, and I've lost a picture of it, was Lil Nas X. And Lil Nas X
I've got him.
Three outfit changes. Yep. Look at that.
Well, he just gets basically a bit more
rocks
undressed
up in
each way.
Like
a gold robe.
A gold robe. Then strips that off, and what's he got underneath?
He's a robot.
Yep.
And
strips that off.
And he's just in a nude suit, essentially.
He's like one of those little Russian dolls.
What would you wear?
Taking the bits.
Yeah, babushka.
Babushkas.
What would you wear, Bickers?
Out of those three?
No. You can pick anything.
I'm down with a horse's head.
So if you ever get invited to this, can we go in a two-piece and can I be the horse's
ass? Could you be
ass?
The back?
Follow Carrie Bickmore and Tommy Little on socials at Carrie Tommy Show.
Now that the podcast is over, Carrie and Tommy are free to check out the Chemist Warehouse half price sale. Get big brand vitamins and cosmetics for half price. Terms and conditions apply. Chemist Warehouse, great savings every day.